Hi everyone, my name is Kevin. Today I want to show you how you can write a simple macro in Microsoft Excel. And as full disclosure before we jump into this, I work at Microsoft. So first off, why would you possibly want to write a macro? Why would you want to do that? Well, let's jump on the desktop and I'll show you a quick example of when macros might be helpful. Here I am on my desktop and I have Microsoft Excel. I have the latest version of Microsoft Excel. This is what comes with Office 365. If you have 2019, 2016, 2013, or any previous version, macros have been around for a little while, so you should be able to follow along, but hey, you should get the latest version. A lot of improvements have come over time. Here I'm gonna click on Microsoft Excel, and why would you want to do macros? Well, let's say that every single month my manager gives me this spreadsheet that has customer names in one column and then the balance due in the other. And let's say that my manager wants me to format this data in a specific way. So I'm going to click on this other tab, and this shows how my manager wants to get the data back. So you see that I had to split the first name from the last name into two separate columns. And then I have another column here that has balance due. And what I've done is for any customer who has a balance due, I've formatted the balance in a specific way. So you'll see, you know, here's my customer data, and then here's where I need to land. And so what I could do is I could just manually do this every single month, where I just go split the columns, I apply the formatting, and it's lots of manual effort to do that, and it'll take me some time. But what we could do is, instead of me manually doing it, I could just outsource that work to the computer and I could have the computer do it for me. So that's what you do with macros. You could take those repetitive tasks that you do again and again and again, and instead you could have a macro do it for you. So sound good? Well, how do we get a macro to do this? Well, the first thing that we want to do is we're going to want to record or create a macro. But what you could do is you could jump through all these different pivots on the top of Excel and you won't find anything related to macros. So what we need to do is, first we need to turn on the pivot that'll have a view that lets you add a macro. And how do we do that? Well, the first thing that we're gonna do is click on the file menu. So that'll open up file, and then we're gonna go to the very bottom of the file menu to options. Okay, so let's click on options. And I know this is the last place anyone ever wants to go. You just land in this view with lots of little checkboxes and lots of different controls. Probably have no idea what half of them do. But anyway, once we're in options here, what we're gonna do is we're gonna scroll down and then we're gonna click on customize ribbon. So let's click on that. And what you'll see is on the right-hand side, these are all the different pivots that you see on the ribbon. The macro option lives under developer. So we wanna check that box and then we're gonna click on okay. What you'll see happened is now we have a new pivot called developer. And so I'm gonna click on that. And there's an option now. So within here, you have something that says macros. So I could click on that. That'll show me all macros that currently exist as part of this workbook. I don't have any yet because I haven't created any. What I could do is I could record a macro, and then I have a number of other options. So we're gonna walk through a few of these as we go on, but the first thing that we wanna do is we wanna learn how to record a macro. So I'm gonna record a macro that does all the formatting here to get it to look like this formatted sheet. So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna first click on record macro, and I'm gonna call it format customer data. One of the things that you'll see is for the macro name, you can't have any spaces, so you either have to just connect all the words, or you could use underscores, kind of however you wanna handle that. I'm just gonna use underscores here. Okay, so click OK, and now what you'll see is the macro is recording, and so I have this button that I could click on to stop recording once I'm done. But I'm not done yet because I haven't done anything. So the first thing that we're gonna do is I'm gonna insert another column here, and I'm gonna call this one first name, and then we're gonna call this column last name. And then what I wanna do is I'm gonna highlight all these names, and what I'm gonna do is go to the data view, and we're gonna click on text to columns, and I'm gonna say delimited, next, and we're gonna separate these by a space. So I'll click on next and finish, and there you go. All my first names are now separated from my last name. And then for the balance due, I'm gonna highlight these. I'm gonna click on home. We're gonna go to conditional formatting, and I'm gonna highlight any cell that has a value greater than zero. So we're gonna say greater than, and I'm gonna say zero. And so what you see is now this highlighted any single cell that had a balance due. And so now one thing you'll see is, so I've matched the formatting so it looks like that other sheet that I have. I'm gonna go back to the developer, and now I'm gonna click on stop recording. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm just gonna undo all the changes that I just made. So we're gonna go back, And I'm also just going to copy the customer data over to another sheet just so I have a copy of it. And so what you'll see now is I'm going to go click on macros. And so you see I have this existing macro here called format customer data, and now I could run it. And when I run it, it does all the formatting for me. And so let's say next month when I get a different set of data, I could go ahead and just run that same macro again, and that'll apply all the formatting to my sheet. So it's pretty easy. Now, what I can also do is there's this option called use relative reference. What that means is, let's say that I had my customer data sitting over here instead of in cell A1. Well, right now, if I run the macro, it's not going to do anything because it's not going to format this data because it's in a different position. If instead I say use relative reference, it'll simply use the starting point as the position where it should start running the macro. So let's say I recorded that macro and I used relative references. If I have the active cell here, it would just simply apply all the formatting in this location. So that's what it would do. I'm going to get rid of the formatting for just a moment, and I'm going to bring the data back in. And I want to show something else that you can also do, which is kind of fun. So one way to run your macros, you could click on macros and then you could run it from here. What you can also do is if I click on insert, what I can do is I could insert a button. So we're going to insert a button, and I'm going to, when I click on this button, I'm going to run this macro, the format customer data. So I'll click OK. And now I could title this button. For the button, I change the text to say format data. So now what'll happen is, check out this. Now when I click on the button, it'll simply format all the data for me. So kind of cool, you could use a button or you could click into macros. Either way you want to do that. You can either use a button or simply run it from there. And that way you could apply your macro. One of the things you could also do is if you click on this Visual Basic view, what we're going to do is I'll click into that. And then here you can see the macro that I created. So this is the actual code behind the macro that you're running, and you could kind of work your way through it. Let's say instead of saying first name, you meant to say first name of customer, and maybe you want to say the other one. So you could go ahead and you could modify some of the details of the macro, how it runs. Or let's say that you wanted to, you know, select more cells. Instead of going through C11, you really wanted to go to C20, or maybe C100. So let's say your data always ranges between 50 and 70. Maybe you want to modify that so you just always capture however much data you have. And then you could go ahead and that'll just automatically be saved then. So I'm going to close that, go back to the sheet. And what you need to do then is, if you want to save this sheet, you can't just save it as a normal Excel spreadsheet because it has a macro in it. So when you go to save as, what you'll see is within the save as list, you have your typical just Excel workbook. And then you also have something called an Excel macro enabled workbook. If you want the macro to be attached with your workbook, you're going to want to save it as this type, and then you could go ahead and save. And so this is how you create simple macros in Microsoft Excel. It really simplifies work, especially if you're doing those repetitive tasks again and again and again. There's nothing more draining than having to do a task many, many, many times, let's say every week, every month. And instead, what you could do is, why don't you offload that work to a computer? Computers are great at doing that, you know, predictable, same routine tasks again and again and again. And all you have to do is you just have to record what the computer should do, and the computer will do it for you. Now, if you're at work, you could tell your manager that you came up with this awesome macro and you want to take on more work, or you could just kick your legs back up, tell your manager how hard it is, and then have the macro do the work for you and get a little bit of free time, whichever approach you prefer. Well, that's all I had. I wanted to give you a quick tutorial of how you could create macros in Microsoft Excel. If this was helpful and you were able to create a macro, please give this video a thumbs up. If you want to see more videos like this, hit that subscribe button. And if there are any other videos or any other topics that you'd like to learn about, feel free to leave a comment down below and I'll take a look at it and add it to my list of videos to create in the future. That's all I had. Hope you enjoyed. I'll see you next time. Bye.